Hi there, I'm Rue. Welcome to my video. Welcome back, my subscriberoonies. I put out a poll, and you spoke, and I listened. So today is full of choosy beggars and entitled assholes, parents, and other types of entitled people. What a treat. Today's shout-out is a two-parter. One to Sha4, and your comment. Your voice came out fine, though. You have honestly one of the top 5 voices I have ever heard while on YouTube. Focus on the positives. Am I right or am I right? Thank you, you bring me my day. And Crystal Owens. I love your videos, they always make my day. Even at my worst days, I can't help but laugh and feel a bit better. Aw, I feel honored, thank you. It blows my mind that I can have that effect on people. Your comment did the same to me. Let's get into the cringe, shall we? All black cats are not the same. I'm not sure what category to put this under, but it was kind of wild and I do have proof, so that's mostly why I'm deciding to submit it. There used to be a crazy cat lady who lived down the street from me. She saw my cats, 2 black cats that look almost identical unless you know them and can tell the difference, and sent us like a 4-page letter of how they looked like her cat that went missing. I think his name was Beezer, and she wanted to get to know them and understand their personalities better. Red flag. Red flag. Creepy, but seemingly harmless. I disagree. That right there is a huge red flag. Until one day, one of my cats, Licorice, goes missing. My mom gets a call from our animal hospital, same business, different vet, saying that there's a lady with a cat that appears to be ours who's completely freaking out because she's trying to get him microchipped and vaccinated or something. My mom had to leave work and pick up our screaming cat from the vet, and the lady tried to claim it was Beezer, who came back after being missing for like 3 years. We found out that she'd been luring my cats to her house with wet food and heating pads and pet beds on the front porch. My mom stopped by her house, stole all her cat paint, and let my cat back into her house. The lady moved away, thank God, but she's lucky she grabbed Licorice instead of my other cat, Connor, because he's mean and probably would have tried to hurt her for grabbing him and stuffing him into a crate. He only lets my mom or myself do that because he's not very trusting. Connor wears a collar, but Licorice manages to get out of all of his and hide them. So it's easier to pass Licorice off as Beezer since she thought no one could tell he was our cat. I don't know if she counts as an entitled parent, but cat stealing seems like a common theme. I mean, I'm a mother of 5 cats. Stealing my child because you think it's your child? Actually, it just doesn't sound like she thought it was her child either. It's just, oh, a black cat. Beezer number 2. It's like a crazy child napper is what that is. So it definitely counts. All in all, I feel bad for her because the cat was probably all she had, and when she saw a cat that looked like him and maybe just really wanted to believe she got her beloved pet back, or she's a scammer, who knows? Maybe she's both. Maybe like there's like some subconscious level she's like, it's not my cat, I'm stealing this cat, but then like, but I want to believe that it's Beezer. Like, you a little cray. Attached are pics of the email she sent my mom after the incident. Both of my cats, the white part of the pet bed was taken from the lady's porch so they wouldn't have reason to go back, lol. And the last one is Connor enjoying a walk because he's adorable.
I am truly sorry Licky suffered a trauma at my hands. I understand that you are upset. I would be upset if one of my cats were taken by someone without my permission to an unfamiliar vet and nearly given unneeded vaccines.
She says that as if she has cats. Lady, you lost your cat. Do you have imaginary cats? That might be the reason why you keep stealing other people's cats. How many other cats does she have? Does she have a basement bunker full of other people's cats? Oh my god. Continue.
That is why I tried as hard as I did to communicate with you well ahead to avoid mistakes. It was never meant to be idle prying or a waste of valuable time.
She left a creepy note on the door. Leaving a creepy note on the door isn't communicating.
You stole a cat.
If I had the power to undo something that has already happened, it would be done. When you told the staff at my veterinary hospital to call the police, I felt kicked in the gut. And I continue to feel pretty beaten up.
Your information and photos would have been helpful prior, and still are helpful into the future. The steps you plan to take to identify your cats will be extremely helpful as my friends and I continue to be dedicated to helping Beezer. Your well wishes for Beezer are much appreciated, and sincere well wishes back for your beautiful sweet cats as well.
Leave random cats alone and get your own microchipped before he goes missing. That is very true. It's so upsetting and alarming that the thing is, why would you leave a note? Like, she should have knocked and been like, hi, my name is Susan and I live in the neighborhood and my cat is missing. It's not one of yours, is it? Did you find your cat outside? Like, did you think it was a stray? Could it possibly be my cat? And if people just go, no, actually, this cat is named Licorice and we've had him since when he was a baby and it's definitely not your cat, that would have been a normal thing. Leaving creepy messages and then stealing people's cats when they don't respond, that is not normal, girl. Oh my god, she's giving crazy cat ladies a bad name. I am proudly a crazy cat lady myself, and that lady is just giving us a bad name.
Road rage.
So I was driving to work along the major highway in my city. Pretty normal day. Nothing too bad in terms of weather. All of a sudden, I accidentally cut off entitled mother and her teenager. I mouthed, sorry, in my back mirror and continued driving. Thought it would be over, I did. Nope. Entitled mother starts straight up following me for about 35 kilometers until I exit the highway. But she follows me still. When I get to a sea of traffic lights, entitled mother pulls up beside me. The conversation goes like this.
That was quite rude of you, you know.
Oh, I'm sorry for cutting you off, ma'am.
Sorry doesn't cut it. You're gonna need something much bigger than that.
At this point, I'm getting confused. What?
Get out of your car.
What?
Get out of the car.
No.
You owe us your car after pulling that shit. Get out of the car and give my daughter the keys.
Please note that her daughter was about 14, I'd guess. Not even legal to drive. Fuck no, I don't owe you shit.
Excuse me? How dare you say such vulgar things in front of my daughter?
At this point, I notice the daughter's door is wide open and she isn't in the car. Immediately after noticing this, she appears in front of my window and snatched my keys.
What the fuck?
I quickly grabbed her wrist so she couldn't get away.
Rape! Rape!
This bitch just tried to steal my keys and then had the nerve to accuse me of rape. Luckily, other drivers behind us had seen what had happened and called the police. After they showed up, she and her brat were arrested for theft and attempted grand theft auto. What a fitting end for such crazy lunatics. Can you really arrest a 14-year-old for, like, stealing a car? Or do I just live in Norway and I'm naive? I don't know. Interesting. I'm not saying it's a r/that happened, but this is insane. But then I start thinking about drugs. And people on drugs would definitely be able to pull some of this shit, so I don't know. Okay.
Birthday bitch.
Entitled sister thinks I am a birthday bitch. Okay, so I am 28 going on 29. This story happens on my 27th birthday up in Chicago. I'm gonna name drop a lot of areas by there, so sorry if you get lost. For the first time in 5 years, I had come home to my family for my birthday. Me and my middle sister, 20, had spent the day going to local spots like Portillo's, Plush Pop, a hot dog place, a Baker's Square, and Baskin Robbins for free food, cake, and ice cream. It had been a pretty great birthday. That's so cool. You don't get free things in Norway when it's your birthday. It's sad. But then I went to my grandma's house.
Mistake number one.
My gran, 72, has lived with my oldest sister, 35, and her two kids, her daughter, 18, and entitled brat of a son, 12, for 8 years. She is sadly mostly ignored and even talked down to in her own house. Especially by entitled brat. I get to the house tired from the day out and we all chill and chat. My gran says she wants to go out for burgers for my birthday. I do too, so we discuss where to go. I leaned to Wendy's because my family's a bit tight on cash, and I ate most of the day. My sister insists we go out for a real birthday, though. When I ask why,
because entitled brat here has friends coming over, and they want to go out.
Cue my lovely grandmother.
Why is he having friends over on her birthday? Isn't that rude to do to her?
Yes, Grandma. Yes, it is. My sister explained they planned this playdate
ages ago, not expecting me to actually visit.
Again, Grandma chips in.
She's been talking to us all the last 3 weeks on her excitement about coming up for the first time in years. It should be up to her if we go out.
I say all I want is Wendy's burger and cake. I think it's left at that. My gran goes to nap, and my sis returns to my side. She tries convincing me, again, to go out. That we can get burgers all together and go to Dave and Buster's. I have only seen commercials for this place, so go, what's that? My sister grins like she's won the lottery. An adult's arcade! I frown. I hate arcades. The only reason I ever go is one round of DDR. And I am one of those once I'm bored or done, I want to leave. I explain I'd rather not spend my birthday trapped at a glorified bar. She offers a different arcade in the area called Gameworks. I tell her maybe, and she trots off to tell entitled brat. I really do not want to go to this place, but my younger sis, niece, entitled brat, and his friend all tell me it'd be great to go. About 2 hours pass, and then something clicks as my sis asks if I have decided. Wait, Grandma won't spend all night at an arcade. My sister's face drops and her son grimaces, saying he doesn't want her there. It's my birthday, not yours. I want Grandma there. The woman's 72, I only have so many more birthdays with her. My sis claims she shall see if she wants to go. Meanwhile, rest of my family begs to go to the arcade still. I say probably, but I still want Gran to go, since when she's ready to leave, at least I can leave too. My sister comes back and tells me Gran's too tired. She says we should just go without her. I frown a bit, having hoped I'd get my birthday with everyone. Plus, she'd be away home at a normal time. So I clarify, wait, she doesn't even want to do burgers? My sister shrugs and says, guess not. I go to talk to her and my sister stops me. She says, we can always do burgers at home. I look uneasy by this and say, I want Wendy's since I don't live by one. Plus, I have shit tons of birthday coupons. My sister looks through the coupons and sees one for Fuddruckers. There happens to be one by both arcades. I warn her it's going to be about 15 bucks per person at minimum. She says it's no issue. She has money on hand because the arcades are a bit pricey. So we all decide to head there to eat. This is mistake two. My younger sister and I get in one car. My older sister and her kids in another. They take the highway to get to the food. My younger sister and I have to take the side roads since there's tolls. I have a 20, but all tolls are charge only on the way to this place. My sister calls me after about 20 minutes of driving.
Where the fuck are you?
Still driving?
Well, you need to hurry up. This place is packed.
Yeah, it's a bit famous for great food.
And why didn't you tell me burgers are 12 bucks here?
I did. I said 15 bucks minimum.
I thought you meant for a full meal.
I apologize, feeling I could have explained a bit better, and tell her we are 10 minutes away. We get to her, she has food in hand.
About time.
I ask her for a 20. She stares at me.
I thought you had a coupon for free birthday food.
Yes, for a free birthday shake and free fries. I still need to actually get the burger.
Well, go get it then.
My little sister and I stare at her now. Wait, you want me to pay for your burger? My little sister, God bless her soul, pipes up.
If Grandma came, she'd have paid for everyone.
My older sister gets up and gets in line, and she complains the whole time about it not being worth it. How we shouldn't have come. How she's pissed to spend 20 a person almost. I remind her that all I wanted was Wendy's and a cake. Soon we get to the front. I ask for the double barbecue burger and hand them my birthday coupon. They ask for ID to prove that I'm not scamming them out of 9 bucks of food. My sister scoffs at this and hands them a 20. Before she goes to leave, she says,
don't eat too slowly. I want to get to the arcade at a reasonable time.
I proceed to eat my food as normal, also wanting to be back home soon. She claims I ate slowly on purpose. Soon it's time to go and we get to the GameWorks arcade. Turns out that today is 21 and ups only. My sister complains to me like it's my fault, and I go, oh well, let's go home. My sister then reminds me Dave & Buster's is 15 minutes away. I begrudgingly agree to still go for the rest of the group's sake. Mistake 3. We get there, we go in, and my sister hands me a game card with 10 bucks on it, cause I won't play as many games. While she's right, it's still annoying to me. I go in and see mostly kids' games, a few giant arcade games, and sports games. I start with the arcade games, Dig Dug, Space Invaders, and Pac-Man. Then me and my younger sister do two rounds of DDR. The first goes nicely. The second, my older sister comes to watch and mocks me for already being tired after already dancing 3 songs. Once done, her and I go to the bar. She asks if it's as bad as I thought. I admit, it isn't awful, but I am done and I have no other games I want to play. She says we will leave once her son's done playing, no sooner. I ask if I can at least get a drink since I'm stuck. She says nothing's stopping me. She orders herself a kitty cocktail. I order one of the drinks that comes with a toy inside. She makes fun of my choice and puts down a 5. The bartender tells her she owes 17 because of my drink. Oh no, she's paying for herself. I stare at her and remind her I just asked permission so she could pay. She literally yells she's already got me a 15 buck burger, a 10 buck game card, and a cake at home. I hand over the 20 I got from my youngest sister as a gift. I stay at the bar for what feels like forever and the tender, seeing it's my birthday, gives me a free refill on the drink for free and tells me I can keep the decorative toy, a Kraken. He apologizes to me saying he'd get me another, a dragon, but they ran out. I'm just happy he isn't making me pay for my second drink. Soon the kids are in the prize booth. My nephew gestures me over and says, grab anything off the candy counter, it's on me. Okay, maybe he isn't such a brat. I grab some Laffy Taffy, Fun Dips, Reese's, and Pixie Sticks. The woman at the front says we can also use the leftover 2 bucks on my game card for a variety candy bag. I agree and am handed a literal grocery bag of Skittles, M&Ms, Starbursts, Sweet Tarts, and Snickers. She claims she put extra in for the birthday girl. Again, not such a bad night at the end. Soon it's time to leave. My little sister and I realize both our phones died during the arcade events. We tell Big Sister because we don't know how to get home. Mistake 4. She tells us to keep up, gets in her car, and drives off. She's already down the road by the time we escape the packed lot. We are pissed, but thankfully we get about 4 cars behind her. Then she gets to the highway home. At least I got toll change thanks to spending that 20. We try to keep up, but my little sister's truck can't really go above 70. My big sister is a speed demon. We lose her. I sigh, annoyed, but thankfully it's not that hard to get home from here, right? Wrong. We come up to a fork that says Chicago right, Rockford left. Me and my sister slow down to the Chicago exit. Turns out that was the long way and lead to the actual city. We live in a suburb outside of it. My sister calls us to ask where we are, cause she got home. I explain where we left. She laughs. You morons, you were supposed to head to the Rockford cause it leads to the O'Hare exit. My sister and I are both pissed at this point, cause she drove at like 80 despite knowing the truck can't drive too fast. We get home tired and pissed. I got to plug my phone in, my sister mocks us again about going the wrong way. I am shaking, trying not to let all my anger out, as I remind her we had no GPS. Thankfully, I spot Gran and go to her to calm down. I apologize that we took so long and tell her what happened with getting back home. She just nods and doesn't say anything. I am lost. She's never been this upset before. I ask what's wrong.
Well, you left me here. I would have liked to know you guys were going.
I go pale as my heart drops and ask her what she means. She says,
nobody came to even tell me you were leaving. I would have woke up. I had a good 2-hour nap after all.
I soon can feel the heart that dropped speed to 1,000. I stand practically knocking the chair I was in to the floor as I storm to the living room where my sister is. You bitch! My sister blinks, shocked at my outburst. She tries to play innocent as I berate her in front of everyone, the nephew's friend included. I accuse her of purposely leaving Grandma home. My gran comes up, shocked hearing me.
Wait, you told her you tried waking me and I was fine with you all going without me?
And this, apparently to my big sister, is just something worth a shrug.
Well, if this birthday bitch had her way, none of us would have had fun.
My gran and I both get to yelling. Me explaining how she ruined my birthday. My gran telling her not to call me a bitch because I just wanted a home birthday. My older sister reiterates,
she's been a birthday bitch all day,
claiming I should just be grateful to celebrate a birthday at my age at all. She then goes on about how I shouldn't expect her to pay for my food, drink, etc. After what felt like an hour of yelling, I go outside to cool down, the tears rolling. I only cool off when my niece comes out with a small gift in hand. She says she did the best she could, and I open it to see a little charm bracelet. I thank her, and she says my gran wants me back to give me my gift and cake. I follow her in. I see a chocolate cake and two more small gifts on the table. I sit and do the birthday routine and go to videotape it. My older sister knocks my phone from my hand saying, "You don't have to tape everything." I give her a glare and I'm about to get up, having more than enough at this point. My gran stops me and cuts the cake. I decline the piece and that's when my sister hits my absolute last straw.
What? Is my $5 cake not good enough for you?
I stand again, yelling.
You're really gonna brag about getting a discount cake after using it as a part of your reason not to spend so much while out?
She explains she got it from the neighbor's bakery at a discount, letting them use our pool all summer. She explains it's usually 20 bucks a cake, but I'm still mad.
Listen, even if I like chocolate cake, which I don't, you shouldn't brag about getting it at a discount after literally making it seem like the cake is part of my gift from you.
This starts the same fight from earlier of her calling me an entitled birthday bitch. I took a piece of the cake and shoved it in my mouth yelling,
"There! I ate it!"
and went to watch TV with my gran and little sister. I admit that last part was a bit childish, but I just wanted her to see just how little I cared. Sadly, it had the opposite effect. To this day, my big sister claims I'm the asshole that overreacted and started a fight in front of guests, that I got up dramatically and smeared cake all over my face, like a child having a tantrum, and even still calls me a birthday bitch. I meanwhile tell people that this is by far the worst birthday I have ever had. Edit, since so many people mentioned it, she no longer lives at my gran's house. I am so happy for your grandmother. Oh my god. It really disgusts me how some people treat older people as if they're not even people anymore. They're just like wallets for them to mooch off of. Like, they're adults. Just because they're wrinkly doesn't mean that their brain is gone. Doesn't mean that they can't do things for themselves. It doesn't mean that they can't be independent people who live their own lives and make their own decisions. I just wanted to note though, when you said that you're one of those people who just knows when you've had enough, like, yeah, you had a good time and then you want to leave because you're done. I'm one of those people. People always ask me like, oh, didn't you have a nice time at the party? And I'm like, I did. I had a swell time. And now I'm done. And I want a nap. I just know when I'm done is all. Like, I have like a bomb ass time. I like doing things 100%. Like, either I'm at the party 100% or I'm back at home at my own place in my bed having a nap at 100%. So it's either or.
Let's get down to business of non-demonio.
Entitled Parent ruined my movie experience. When I was little, I want to say around 4 or 5, my mom took me to the movies to see a new cartoon that came out. I can't exactly recall the movie, but I think it was a summer thing they did where they showed old movies. And I think it was Mulan. So my mom was getting the snacks and told me to go to the theater where the screening was to get some seats. So I went and chose some pretty nice seats in the middle row, about 3 or 4 seats away from the aisle. Now I'm sitting there as the previews start and the theater starts to get a bit crowded. But I watch them and wait for my mom to come sit with me. As I'm watching, I hear a loud, nasally voice of an older woman who says,
excuse me.
Reminder, I'm just a little kid. The loud voice scares me and I look at the aisle and see said older woman walking towards me with her kid. Snacks and drinks, and she says,
what do you think you're doing, you little brat?
I was beyond confused and scared and just said, "I'm waiting for my mommy to come and sit with me."
She demanded I get up and move. And being the good kid I was, who always listened to adults because that's what I was told to do, listen and respect adults, so I get up and move out of her way. To which she says,
"I had these seats saved for me and my kid."
I explained I didn't know and could feel myself starting to want to cry, but I kept myself together. She then said,
"You are a lying brat. You think you're better than my son? My son and I always sit here. Now get lost."
I ran away to an empty seat closer to the screen and just started crying quietly when my mom came over and found me. She asked me what was wrong and I told her what happened. And when she asked me who it was, I looked back at where they were and she just glared at me with a death glare so scary that I immediately turned back around and shook my head, went quiet and just laid against my mom as I slowly calmed down and we watched the movie. My memory is a little fuzzy as to what the movie was, but I'm pretty sure it was either Mulan or a re-showing of The Lion King. It makes me so sad that that's old.
That's when I was little. Those movies came out when I was little. How is that old? Oh my god. They're old enough to be re-showing some things? Okay.
But they're classics though. They're good. So they deserve to be re-shown. It's just...
That made me feel a little old.
I'm really impressed that a 4 or 5-year-old could go pick out seats though. Like, I would just be straight up terrified that my kid would be kidnapped. And possibly put a leash on them. I would be that parent to put a leash on the human child. Yes, I would. Yes. Works on my feline babies. I would definitely do it to a child. Fun fact, I saw one on sale in the gift shop when I was in Iceland, so
it's starting to become socially acceptable. Paging Dr. Privilege.
My dad's house is 3 blocks away from a hospital. This will be important. Someone started parking their Mercedes in my dad's driveway, which had a sign clearly stating no parking, private property, for several days. My dad first left a note telling them not to park in his driveway or he'd call the cops and have him ticketed. Next day, the car was there yet again. So, true to his word, dad called the cops and he got ticketed. Next day, my dad's friend was sitting out on dad's front steps when the same Mercedes pulls into the driveway. A 30-something guy in a suit and tie gets out and starts angrily stomping up the stairs. He stopped 3 steps below my dad's friend and demands to know if he was the homeowner. Dad's friend says no and calls for my dad. Dad comes out and the guy immediately demands to know why my dad had called the cops on him and got him ticketed. My dad calmly tells him that since it is his driveway and this asshole guy had been parking there day after day without permission, even though he'd been told not to, he had every right to call the cops when someone trespasses on his property. The guy all but yells at my dad, "I'm a doctor! I can park wherever I want to! Everywhere else is taken and I'm not paying to park in the fucking lot! It's not like you're even using it anyway!" Turned this asshat worked at the hospital and figured since he was a doctor, he had a right to park in my dad's driveway. And my dad was using his garage, which this asshat's Mercedes was blocking. He went on to tell my dad that he needed to pay for this entitled asshat's ticket. My dad laughed in his face and told him to shove that bullshit, and the ticket, up his own ass. And as a doctor, he would know where to find it. Burn! Dad also told him that if he saw his car in his driveway again, he'd have it towed. My dad said the guy's face turned red as a chili pepper, and he almost expected to see steam coming out of his ears. He then began cussing my dad and threatened to sue, but my dad cut him off, telling him if he didn't get off his property, he'd happily throw him down the stairs. There were 30 steps and this asshole was on a 27th. Dad's friend smiled evil at the guy. Mr. I'm a doctor, realizing he wasn't gonna get his way, turned and stomped down the steps, switching between threatening litigation and cussing my dad out. But only after he'd gotten out of range of my dad's hands and feet. Never sued and my dad never saw him or his Mercedes again. That's too good.
I feel like this is what happens when entitled parents raise a child like, oh, you will be a doctor, my dear son, you're the best in the universe, you're entitled to everything. And then this guy actually grows up to be a doctor and he's like, well, I'm a doctor, I can park wherever I want. Thank you for submitting that, Raven Fox. That was hilarious.